1989 Wetaskiwin Sabres, Central Alberta High School Football League champions, a season to celebrate. Indeed, the 1989 Sabres season was a good thing, a season to celebrate. The 1989 season opened in Rocky Mountain House on Friday, September 18th. Right off the opening kickoff, the Sabres set the tone for the season. A 50-yard kickoff that Troy almost breaks for a touchdown. No matter, because on the very next play, the first play from scrimmage in the 1989 season, Troy goes for 45 yards and the opening score for the season. 7-0 Sabres. But Rocky was to make a comeback. Excellent execution and a group of top-notch athletes helped Rocky to a 13-7 lead in this game. The Sabre offense had some big plays of their own. Into the fourth quarter, the score was 28-7 Rocky until Derek matches up with Chuck Klubine for this touchdown to make the score 28-14. The Sabres put on a valiant late effort, but could get no closer. Rocky has a great game and a great season, finishing 6-0-1 and winning the Tier 3 Provincial Championship. The Sabres lose this one and are 0-1. Just a short 16 hours from Rocky Mountain House, it's to the tournament at Emmy Lazard in Edmonton, where the Sabres play Harry Ainley, Ross Shepherd, here seen in the dark blue uniforms, Archbishop Jordan is the opponent seen here. And lastly, Jasper Place Composite High School. An excellent day, and the boys had a lot of fun. A big thanks to Wade Matke, volunteer trainer. Wade was a big help this year in many aspects of the Sabres' successful season. It's Friday, September 15th, a great day for football. Camille J. LaRouge, Cougars are in town. Weapon X is there to see the game. Here's big defense by Clayton Tate. Early in the game. That big defensive play led to Troy's first touchdown, and the Sabres lead 7-0. Watch as number 65, Jason Henderson, causes a turnover here. More big defense by the Sabres, hard hitting and swarming tackling. But the big defense gives up the big play. Camille LaRouge strikes back and ties the score at 7. A couple of big plays. A nice catch by Chuck, and this kickoff return by Darren are two of the highlights from the middle of the game. The pitch was the Sabres' bread and butter on offense all year. Here Troy Schmidt rips off a 40-yard gain and sets up his own 10-yard touchdown, making the score 15-14 in front of a good crowd. They were watching a very close football game. A great play by Sabre defensive back Trevor White. Another big play by Jason Henderson. Watch as Harley Skora crashes through to block the field goal. Next, a couple of fine possession receptions as Derek Booth hooks up with Sean Matioski. Clayton Tate chips in with a fine punt return. Chuck Klubine and Darren Grote have a couple of big runs, and it sets up a 1 yard quarterback plunge by Derek Booth. The score is tied at 21 with under 2 minutes to play. The conversion by Derek Booth makes the score 22-21, the Sabres in the lead. Now it's up to the defense to make the big plays and hold on to that lead. Riley Moore bats down a pass. Drew Guzzi makes a fine interception. Interception by Harley Skora secures a 22-21 victory and evens the Sabres record at 1-1. It's just one day later when the Sabres take on their next action, exhibition play. Saturday, September 16th, and the opponent is Swinston Churchill from Calgary. That was a big sack by Warren Johnson. A big run out the right side of the line. Excellent blocking leading for Lee Schottschneider. Swinston Churchill takes a 21-0 halftime lead on this touchdown, but the Sabres fight back. Great catch by Chuck Klubine. Derek Booth with a good run up the middle. And that set up the Sabres' only touchdown of the game, making the score in this one 28-7. But the big point was experience, and watch the experience Darren hands out to some Swinston Churchill tacklers. Here's a big play. Lonnie with the white helmet hits his offensive man so hard he knocks him back into the ball carrier number 15 and takes him right off his feet. A big play by a big guy. Another fine play. Watch as Derek threads the needle to Luke Myers. Great catch. The final score would be 28-7. It's Friday, September 22nd. The opponent, Lindsay Thurber in Red Deer. Big defense to start the game, and the Sabres came up with some big plays early, but mistakes would cost them. This play from Chuck to Sean was called back. But the Sabres continued to make some big offensive and defensive plays. Watch the swarming and hard-hitting tackling here. The pitch, once again, works for the Sabres. Twice in a row. Great lead blocks by Darren and Jim Bristow. great play in the backfield by Harley and almost recovering the fumble. A sack by Clayton Tate. Sean Matioski, the receiver here. Second team All-Star in Central Alberta High School football. 12 catches on the season for 275 yards. A great possession receiver. Harley Scora with a nice defensive play. Great lead blocking by the offensive line opens a huge hole, and Darren rumbles for 20 yards on a fine draw play. This Lindsay Thurber touchdown made the final score 37-0. The game was much closer than the score indicated. The Sabres were just unable to put the ball in the end zone. The loss puts the Sabres record at 1-2 in league play. But the Sabres played hard right until the last whistle. The next Sabres action, Sunday, October 1st, versus the Camrose Trojans in Wetaskiwin. This first play, the Mean Team sets up Troy's 6-yard touchdown. And the score stands 7-0 Sabres. One of the early game highlights is this punt return by Chuck Klubine. Drew comes up with an interception deep in Camrose's end. Drew Guzzi was a second team All-Star defensive back, third in the league with 4 interceptions. Drew's interception set up this 2-yard plunge by Darren Grote. Great blocking on the offensive line. Here's an electrifying 65-yard touchdown scoring play from Derek to Sean Matioski. Watch the huge hole here as Darren rumbles for 10 yards and his second touchdown of the game. Lee scores a touchdown from 13 yards, plunging across with great second effort. Another big play by Lee. Troy scores from 6 yards out. The final in this game would be 38-15. The Sabres even their record at 2-2. The Sabres spend lots of time on the bus this year. Here's a little peek at life with the Sabres on the bus.
I gotta run in.
Goodbye, tiebreak.
Alright, what? No camera in here. Back to the front, back to the front.
Four guys trying out.
That's a nice bike.
Smart.
Kind of wrong place.
We're not content until we get everything.
What?
We're not content until we take everything.
Well, that's right. That doesn't stop here.
We have only begun.
Don't you hide, I can't get up.
So what's that stuff? So your feet clean?
Most of the way, it seems the boys have found an alternate form of transportation for the last few miles. The first big play from the Stettler game, Troy with a great run around the left side, breaking tackles and almost going all the way. Lee with a great run off the right side, some excellent lead blocking by the offensive line. It sets up Troy's first touchdown from 7 yards, and the Sabres take an early 7-0 lead. The defense helps maintain the lead. Good pressure forces the quarterback to throw into coverage, and Drew makes the interception. Derek Booth and Lee Schottschneider match it up for a fine gain. More swarming and hard-hitting defense. The Sabres' middle defense gives up no yards. And the score at this point stands 26-14, Stettler in the lead. Here's a great punt return by Troy. 75 yards to make the score 26-21. It was an MVP season for Troy, but watch as his teammates do a lot to help him out. First, Steve Dyka at the right of the screen, number 63. He makes one block. Takes that man off his feet and goes for the next man. As a matter of fact, he doesn't just take out two, he takes out four would-be Stettler pursuers. The next scene you'll see is Drew Guzzi. Having taken out two blockers, you see the Stettler players at his feet. That was the final block that's sprung Troy on this great punt return. Now it's the defense's turn. A couple of big plays. Here, Clinton Cryer with a great pass rush brings the quarterback down. The Sabres would never give up and come very close in the dying moments, but lose a heartbreaking 26-21 decision and go to 2 wins and 3 losses on the season. Another insight for you is early morning practices. The players are usually quite a sight so early in the morning.
Fort Delbert, that's more dark. Morning, guys.
Back of Darren in the morning, going into the dressing room. Shh, we'll follow him into the dressing room and see what happens. No anthrax this morning. The ghetto blaster must have blown its speakers. James Dahl's here this morning. Here's a good look at him. Anything happening here? No. Veterans.
I can't get it undone.
Fine work. Gotta get that.
Boy's got the wrong underwear.
Who's this? I farted in my bag.
That's mine.
Yeah,
mine.
Yeah, mine.
Morning, Luke.
Even though it's early morning, the players are always in a rush to go out and get into the cool, fresh fall air. We'd like to thank the managers who did such an excellent job all year helping support the Sabres program. Here's Randy McCullough. Kim Hassett. Also helping out for part of the year was Wilma Van Gierenstein. This is Maria Hall. And Lisa Clark. Thanks, girls. Great job. You've got to arrive early to get a good seat for a Sabres home game. Here you see the Sabres' number one fan, Mrs. Schmidt, arriving early to claim one of the Sabres' sky boxes. It's Friday, October 13th, and we'd better say a prayer. The opponent is the Lacombe Rams, and the Sabres are in a must-win situation. A big block punt. The boys are working hard. Tom Amon comes up with the recovery. Steve Dyka makes the block on this play, and a blitz on the next play. It was big plays like this that made him a second team Central Alberta High School Football League All-Star in 1989 at linebacker. Another hard-working block by Drew Guzzi. Chris Hardy scoops it up and takes it in for the touchdown. Great blocks on the next play. Spring. Darren, with a great effort from 5 yards, bowls over for the touchdown. Big defense from Drew and Dalbert Atkins, number 13. Lee with a big catch here. The replay will show, even though the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage by the Lacombe rusher, and this fine effort from Chuck Klubein sets up Derek's 30-yard field goal. Derek Booth was a second-team All-Star at place kicker, scoring 33 points. From 31 yards out, Chuck and Sean match up for 44-yard touchdown pass and run, 31-0 Sabres. Longest pass play of the year, 99 yards, pass and run from Derek to Chuck. Make the score 38-0 Sabres in the third quarter. Chuck was a first-team All-Star, scored 5 touchdowns, passed for 3 touchdowns. Besides all of his great catches, he also had 219 yards rushing. Here is a 104-yard touchdown, making the score 45-0. Troy Schmidt, Central Alberta High School Football League MVP. 825 yards and second in scoring. Another block punt, this time by number 47, Tom Amon. Watch the Sabres go for the ball. Here's a big kickoff return by Troy Schmidt. This return and convert makes the score 52-13. The last highlight is a Lacombe highlight, but certainly worthy of making any highlight tape. A great catch by number 4 in the end zone. This is the final scoring. It makes it 52-20. The Sabres are back to 3 wins and 3 losses and guaranteed of making the playoffs. Now it's Friday, October 20th in Leduc. The Sabres don't get off to that great a start, a little slow. Here's Troy's first touchdown from 2 yards. From 31 yards out, Derek bombs to Chuck, 13-0 Sabres. But then the scoring starts to come hot and heavy. It's late in the second quarter. Clayton sacks the Leduc quarterback for 2 points, a safety touch, 15-0. Lee's 3-yard run makes the score 22-0. Chuck on a 50-yard run, and it's 29-0. Troy from 25 yards out, 37-0. Warren recovers this fumble and sets up Troy's 3rd touchdown. The score will be 43-0. The Sabres scored 3 touchdowns in the first 2 minutes of the third quarter. Chuck and Sean match up once again, 49-0. Not every play went for a touchdown, but there was still some fine execution. Luke with a great catch. Chad Schmidt runs it in from 5 yards out, 55-0. Chad again from 3 yards. The score stands 62-0. The score might have been higher. Watch as Trevor White makes a great interception, returns it for a touchdown, but a penalty brought it back just outside the goal line. Chuck Klubine caps the scoring on a 68-0 victory with a 60-yard reverse. The Sabres finish 4-3, tied with Stettler, placed fourth based on the 26-21 defeat to Stettler during the regular season. Now it's Wednesday, October 25th. Semi-final action in Central Alberta High School football. A great fall day sees Rocky jump out to a quick 13-0 lead. But the Sabres come back. This block punt helps them a long way in the first half. Rocky elects to fake a field goal, but Drew is there to intercept and snuff out the drive. Chuck and Sean once again, this time for 46 yards. It sets up a 1-yard touchdown run by Troy. The score stands 13-7, Rocky leading. Then Derek matches up with Chuck Klubine. At this point, the score is 15-14. The Sabres take a lead for the first time in the game. Derek and Chuck, rather Chuck and Sean match up, and the Sabres have a 21-15 lead. At this point in the game, the score is 22-21, but Tracy Tate makes a great interception and almost returns it all the way. The Sabres go for the field goal from the 15-yard line. But Rocky comes through and blocks the field goal. They march the ball down the field, and with 8 seconds remaining, a field goal attempt from 16 yards. But the snap is botched. When the ball carrier is finally brought down, it's third down. Rocky has one more attempt, 10 yards. Time has run out, and the ball is wide to the right. Troy takes the ball in the air, punts it out. Leading the ball, the tacklers downfield is Warren Johnson, second team Central Alberta High School Football League All-Star for the second year in a row at defensive end. Warren and Steve seal the fate. It makes the final 22-21 for the Sabres in a heart-stopping win over the first place Rocky Rebels. It's on to the league championship for the fourth year in a row. And what better way to celebrate than a meal at McDonald's? And after a nice meal, what's better than a little sleep on the bus ride home? That's if they let you sleep. Right, Coach Mac? Here's a couple of Sabres of the future. Steven in white and Anders Louv in green. They may be good punters, but they're not as good as our own Tracy Tate. The first highlight from the championship game between Lindsay Thurber and the Sabres is a punt that goes out at the 4-yard line. Angling the ball may have hurt Tracy's average and his chances of being an all-star, but his teammates recognize the great job he did all year. Remember, Lindsay Thurber are the reigning champions, and this is the third year in a row Lindsay Thurber and Wetaskiwin have faced each other in the final. Now the score is 9-1 because of this missed field goal. Lindsay Thurber is leading 9-1. The score goes to 16-1. Then Drew comes up with a big interception. And on the very next play, a big momentum shift. Darren Grout rumbles 75 yards for the touchdown. Make the score 16-7. The Sabres, right on the heels of that play, come up with another big play. A perfectly executed two-point convert as Chuck finds Sean Matioski open on the left-hand side. 16-9 is the score at halftime. Early in the third quarter, Derek converts this 32-yard field goal. Great kick. Jason Henderson comes through with a big block punt. Jason was once again a unanimous first-team All-Star at defensive tackle. Tom Amon makes the recovery. Troy sweeps left for 2 yards, and the Sabres take a 19-16 lead. They will never relinquish. Here's a 60-yard burner by Chuck. 26-16. Nobody will touch Chuck when he's in the open field. With the score at 26-23, Sabres leading, Chuck and Sean repeat a familiar sight, and the result is a 51-yard touchdown pass and run. Sabres lead 33-23. Here's a big play, a sack that loses a lot of yardage for Lindsey Thurber. The defense continues to come up big. A fumble recovery on a attempted reverse by Lindsey Thurber. Clayton Tate comes up with the ball. Another fumble recovery deep in the Lindsey Thurber end leads to this Derek Booth field goal. The score stands 36-23. Lindsey Thurber marches down and gets another touchdown. The gap is closed to 36-30. The Sabres get pinned deep in their own end. Feet of Grand Prairie's Trevor Webb would put the game out of reach on a huge 99-yard touchdown. The final 30-20 for Grand Prairie, and an anticlimactic end to a great season for the Sabres. The Sabres finished the season ranked. Some big plays now. Watch as number 61, Stan Morrill, leads downfield on many of these blocks. Stan was the second team All-Star center. Watch the lead block of number 51, Schmidt. On the next play, Jim Bristow, number 49, and Stan Morrow, 61, open a huge hole for Darren. Lee with a great second effort to plunge over the goal line. Troy breaking tackles. Not only is Chuck's sweater ripped, but he almost gets his head ripped off. More second effort. Watch the effort on this two-point convert by Chuck Klubine against LeDuc. Tracy recovering the punt against Grand Prairie. Here's some great lead blocking against Grand Prairie. And Troy breaking tackles. Watch Chuck take the hit and show a lot of Sabre pride in order to make this 2 points. Here Chuck comes through the line and never stops pumping his feet. A great diving catch. One of the best efforts was made by... Let's see, can the coach get him? Okay, we got him, collared. Watch the effort here by Darren Grote. Oh, but the dog is back. There's Bruce Hegerud on the left. Thanks, Bruce. We thought we had him, but the dog is back. This pooch has more lives than a cat. At least he knows to leave the Sabre players alone. By the way, that's a pit bull, buddy. Okay, we got rid of him. But he's back again. And again. What a great effort by the pooch. Now it's time for who wants the ball? Or is this the way the game is supposed to be played?
Okay, you guys, let's not drop the ball anymore.
Oop, oop, oops. Excuse me, but isn't this supposed to go forward? Now, here, somebody wants the ball finally. But maybe he's not quite sure what to do with it when he gets it. You're supposed to run with it. Oh, he knows what to do now. Oh, watch out for your own teammate. Ooh. Your own boo teammate. Derek wants the ball. Derek, do you want? No, I guess not. Oh, yeah, I'll go back and get it. Oh, maybe. Oh. Doesn't look like Chad wants it. Does Tracy want it? What about Chuck? Chad wants it, but when it hits you in the face mask, it's awful tough to hang on to. This punt seems to be a little low. Hot potato. Tracy, now he's got it, now he doesn't. Watch on slow motion. Tracy makes a great move for the football. He's got it, doesn't he? Watch between the two players. There it is. And the Camrose man makes the catch. Here's a sure two-point convert. Oops. Here's a tough play. So you want to be a punter. Boom! Here's a pair of sure hands. Player leave behind. The ball. I got it. Ooh, that came through there awful clean. This guy's dribbling the ball. Don't play basketball, play football. Hey, you guys, get your act together. I've heard of flying by the seat of your pants, but Lee plays by the seat of his pants. Watch the right-hand side of the screen. Stettler's number 59 will get a hold of the back end of Lee. I hope it's only his pants he's got a hold of. Ooh. Lacombe had a tough day against us. Somebody seems to be a little bit ahead of the others here. Playing a little kissy face. This happened twice to us. The referee's trying to help out Steve and a Lindsay Thurber player. And the Sabres took pride on never missing any tackles. Watch here, the great hits against Lacombe. Watch this tackle here. The next one. Oh, no, the next, he's got him. This guy here. Oh, no. Follow the bouncing ball. Now, when in doubt, pick the ball up off the ground and I got it. Sometimes the referees have a hard time of it. Watch as the referee gets... Hey, get out of the way, wouldn't you, huh? John Reed in the background. A big thank you to John Reed for all his help this year as a volunteer trainer. Now here's one. Is the center too far away from the quarterback, or is the quarterback too close to the center, or... Here it is. Who wants the ball? Well, now here's how it's done, guys. Coach Lou will show you. First you warm the hands up. A one, a two, a one, a two, one, two, one, two. A little quicker this time. One, two, one, two, one, two. Now, if the ball's kicked to the side, get the other players out of the way, put your hands up, catch the ball, want the ball, and then accept the glory. Yeah. Nice move, Dalbert. Watch behind Sean. This one should make a blooper film. Watch the trophy. You gotta show something like that again in slow motion. Once again, right behind Vlad are Bruce Hagerud and John Reed, two people who have supported us a great deal and are an integral part of the success of the Sabres program. Thank you, gentlemen. But there's no mistaking it. The Sabres are number one in Central Alberta again in 1989. Maybe, though, it's not because of their musical talents. Here's the Sabres Football Glee Club with a selection of the Flintstones, If You're Happy and You Know It, and Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
And the Flintstones are on, so.
Okay, rookies, all together. One, two, three.
Flintstones, beat the Flintstones.
Do the job, do the job.
No, they didn't sing at Ross's wedding, but they did graciously bow out, I suppose you could say, for Ross to make a big play. Probably a real nice catch by anybody's standards. He and his lovely bride, Colleen, were married on November 11th, and all the Sabres wished them happiness in a long life together. Yes, you did it. And many more nights of slow cheek-to-cheek dancing. Now it's time for a look at the Sabres at their best. Yes, that was my lovely wife, Sue. Sue puts together all of the music for this tape, and I'm very proud that she's here to help me with it. More seriously, here's a look at every one of the 1989 Wetaskiwin Sabres. A season to celebrate. And a proud tradition.